his own right, but I'll tell you, there he is with the belt. The Intercontinental Champion, Ken Patera. And he'll be going against Cal Ribben in just a moment. He'll be going against the very popular.
No, he's not going against me. No way.
The Giant will be here. I was checking Andre the Giant. He was playing cards earlier tonight in one of the hospitality suites here at the Spectrum. And very cool, just sitting there. I was checking the hands. One of his fingers is the size of two of mine. You know, just, look, here he comes. Everybody loves Andre.
Hey, if he cheats at cards, who's going to argue with him?
I'll never tell him. Here he is, Andre the Giant, folks. And Patera is just staring. He says, what have I got myself into now?
Andre has taken beatings. You notice that his forehead is pretty well scarred up.
I see some new scar tissue on there.
Yeah, he got beat up in New York. You know, I do the color there with Vince from Madison Square Garden.
He got beat. But you know, I gotta understand whether the so-called strongest man in the world, the former Olympian Ken Patera, can actually lift Andre. He got a hernia trying to pick him up, I believe. Patera is just an incredible athlete, though. Tremendous wrestler. Okay, let's go to ringside. Here we go.
We will find out if he can lift him.
Event of the evening. It is set for one fall with a 1 hour time limit. It is for the Intercontinental Championship. Introducing first the challenger from the French Alps, weighing 476 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
They love him.
Yeah, they do.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent this evening from Portland, Oregon, 278 pounds, he is the current Intercontinental Champion, Ken Patera.
What do you suppose is going through Ken's mind as this match is about to begin?
Well, I think I'd check the house and see the fastest, most direct route out of here, if need be, and it may need be.
Well, here's he's serious. He plans to defeat him.
I know he does.
Plans to take him, Dick.
All right, Dick Worley and the belt. Okay, we got it.
Intercontinental belt. Dick, hold it somewhere, please. Hold it up.
Where do you want it? All right, there's what it's all about here, fans.
Then put it in a safe place. The last time, Dick,
Patera,
they were going to take your arm with the belt.
Patera saw me with the belt. Yes. I was holding the belt under the table a couple of months back. And does he know I still have it?
Put it behind you, Dick. Dick, I'm nervous.
I'll put it behind you.
Crazy. All right, put it behind me.
Here's a ritual which gets the fans going on every time he wrestles here. Getting out of his outer clothing, Patera makes sort of, a ritual of it.
Andre's patient about it. That's okay.
He's a very patient guy.
Yeah.
But why not?
Another French wrestler. Well, Andre's establishing who's boss in the ring quite early. One arm. Look at him hold him. Picked him right in the...
Kicked him in the buns, folks.
Yeah, humiliated him. Test of strength, Dick.
Andre is just...
Look at the look in his eye. He's gloating. He's laughing at him.
No way. Pressure on that right arm, folks. And
it's like putting your arm into an electric socket, isn't
it? No, thank you.
He wanted to throw him into the ropes.
I'll tell you, as far as I can see, Patera better go wherever the Giant wants him to. I mean, if he fights an arm bar like that or arm pressure, he's going to be in bad shape.
I'll tell you what shape he's going to be in. The body will go and the arm
will remain. That's what I mean.
Yes.
He better go with it.
Well, there's a hit record, the Larson Fayton Band. Who'll be the fool tonight?
What's that on the charts now?
Doing pretty well. It's top 15 on Warner Brothers. Okay. See you as far.
All right. Patera favoring that arm and the elbow. And he's got to be a little concerned that Hey, you notice on the left knee of Patera, now I haven't seen this before, underneath his knee pad, he's got a brace, knee brace on the left knee. Well, this is going to figure into this tonight. I don't know.
It's a vulnerable spot for him.
Dick Worley asking Patera if he... Okay, there's a good shot of it.
That is very painful.
Oh,
that's as much pressure as a human being could ever endure.
Patera got it. Listen, fans, like it or not, look, he's hanging in there. Look at him, look at him. Dick Worley says, you submit, do you give up? And he says, no way. He says, oh, man. I don't think he's ever had trouble like this in all the time he's been wrestling.
And Patera's the strongest man in the world.
Yeah, well, that's what he bills himself as, and truly, he's a great athlete. He's got a brother, Jack Patera, who coaches the professional National Football League Seattle Seahawks.
Yeah, Seahawks, right.
Well, that's your low. Patera was being supported by the ring ropes on his feet and Andre at the head area, and Andre just dropped him like a sack of potatoes. Patera says, I can hear him, he says, get him back, get him back.
Andre's looking at him with absolute contempt and total confidence. He's going to stop Andre with a baseball bat.
Andre tends to hold back because of his size. Boom!
He's throwing him around like he's a baby. A bad move. Bad move, Andre.
Bad move is right.
Now he's vulnerable.
Now he's down. He's down.
That's it. The giant is down.
The giant's down, but Patera is also in bad shape. I don't know that he can do anything about the fact he's...
Yes, he can.
Well, he's got the forearm smash. The
now
giant. All right, they got to break this up, though.
Yeah, but Andre's blue eyes went right up into his
count
forehead.
Of four.
He's stunned.
And there's Patera right back at him again, placing that foot as pressure on the neck. On the lower ring rope. Oh, mercy. Patera, though, he's going to punish the guy.
Yeah. Andre's in weird city and in terrible pain.
Very bad shape. Yeah.
What a turnaround. How quickly it happened.
Get up and fight it. Fight it, big boy.
Hear him? Get up and fight it. Fight it, big boy.
Move it on. One, two,
using the rope.
Three.
I don't know what in the world Patera thinks he's going to do with this guy. He can punish him. He had him down. I don't know how he can keep him totally down for a pin, but who knows? Maybe he's got away.
I think Andre's collecting himself.
All right, Dick Worley watching very carefully for any possible chokeholds. There's a running dialogue between referee Dick Worley and Patera.
How about it, Andre?
How about it, Andre, he said.
That's a punishing hold.
I'll tell you, I don't know if I've ever seen Andre in such a position as he is right now. Look at him, he's crumbling, he's gradually. Now he's all the way down to the mat.
Well, Patera's arms are like white hot steel. The pain has to be more than any human being could ever endure, Dick.
Well, face it, he took a beating at the hands of the giant a while ago, and he's giving it back. That's what it's all about. Worley right down there checking it out. I think he's making sure the chokehold isn't on. He said that a few minutes ago, but it still happens to be true.
Ask him, he's finished.
Ask him, he's finished. That's what he's saying.
Well, it's either got to be a pin or submission.
Worley says, don't worry about it.
The Giant's got to get some strength from somewhere to get out of this predicament. His head's being just shaken like a rag doll by Patera.
Well, that's the problem. You get the Giant down on the mat, and everybody's equal down there.
You got it, Cal. That's right. All right, Patera. Here's the Giant up on all fours, kind of. I say kind of.
He's collecting his strength.
Yeah. Now, all this time Patera's been using up is maybe the Giant's been sort of coasting. I don't know if that's true. But he's getting the strength back from somewhere. Here he comes.
It's like he had a can of spinach, like Popeye the Sailor Man. Here he comes. He's rising.
Just like
no way Patera can stop him now. He's relentless. He's getting up.
Oh, right on the back of that bad knee. He gave him a good shot.
Getting ready for another shot.
Really, I haven't seen Patera that brace before. It could be, oh, look out.
Yeah, Andre just gathers all his strength, and he shoots when he's ready, and he fires. Getting it together again, Dick.
Thinking that there's no action going on, fans, is a mistake because there's a lot going on there. That pressure being maintained on the head and neck area. And then retaliating is Andre. What a smash. Another smash to the back of the knee.
They're coming faster and faster.
All right, you're going to find Patera's going to be a cripple here before long.
Yeah,
all right.
Look how red the thigh is.
Oh, wow. The pain is just, look at him going right back at the giant again.
He's in a bad spot for that.
Couple of quick chops at the back of the knee by the giant.
He's up. He's wobbly, but he's up.
Oh, he's drop kicking. He's drop kicking that knee.
Oh, here he comes at us.
Not again.
Boy, Andre's doing it better than Tony Franklin. Yeah. Sign him up with the Eagles. Talk about a drop kick.
He's going to work on that leg again. Now look at it. Look at it. He's dragging him in the middle of the ring. Here he goes. Four 500 pounds smashing down on that knee.
Right on the brace. The crowd's urging him on.
Yeah, they're saying tear it off. Oh, here he crushes down again on it. All right, Dick Worley says, all right, Patera, what do you want to do? Patera's got to get out of the ring. Listen, you hear the pain. He's crazy with pain tonight. Listen to him. Listen to him. Oh, he's going off. He's going off, fans. He's leaving the ring. Look at him. He's had enough. Do you believe that? Whew.
Well, he did a Pat Benatar. He gave it his best shot, and it didn't work, Dick Graham. You like that, huh?
Yeah, I love it.
Gave it his best shot. He tried. What are you going to do?
All right, let's get the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 9 minutes, 17 seconds, Ken Patera counted out of the ring. Your winner, Andre the Giant.